Hi folks, welcome to Solara Technical. In today's video, I'm summarizing my upcoming talk at UTC. In my last video, I invited you to visit us at UTC. The link's at the end of this video. My talk is about what a ground is and its various uses. There are about as many grounds as there are applications. I'll cover the most important ones and how they're used to protect people, equipment, and buildings. So, what is a ground? It's simply a point of reference, which all other potentials are measured to. Without two points at different potentials, the concept of a ground is meaningless. Convention places the potential of 0 volts at the node in the circuit designated as the ground. The center of this resistor divider can be thought of as a virtual ground for the meter and the top of the resistor. Another way to think of a ground is the place to which all current returns, and I'm talking about hole flow here, not electron flow. As stated earlier, grounds have as many uses as they have forms. There are earth grounds, chassis grounds, and signal grounds for both analog and digital circuits. There are virtual grounds, soft or spongy grounds, and hard or solid grounds. There are capacitive grounds, high resistance grounds, and low resistance grounds. There are even floating grounds. As you can see, there are many types of grounds, and no doubt many I have not even mentioned, each with their own unique uses. In my talk, emphasis will be placed on how various grounds might be used to reduce noise and/or protect people, property, and equipment. Sometimes these goals can be at odds. When they are, we put safety first and noise reduction second. Besides their use in measuring potentials, what are some of the applications grounds are good for, and how are they used? At UTC, I'll discuss 5. They are grounds to protect devices from humans and our electrostatic discharge, grounds to protect humans from the devices and possible electrical shock. In communications equipment, grounds are used to reduce or eliminate noise, whether it be differential mode or common mode or induced fields or radiated fields. In buildings, grounds protect against lightning strikes, which can cause fire or physical damage. And finally, grounds are used extensively in environments where humans may be at risk, like in a substation or a factory. I hope you can attend my talk. As always, if you'd like help with anything related to power, please give us a call. We're here to help. Thanks for watching.